listening.
I've got something you want.
Yeah, 250 grand.
Hmm. And your mother.
You leave her out of this cover.
Now listen, Lo. If anything happens to those women, she'll be up for aiding and abetting, accessory to kidnap and murder. Think about it, Lo. She'll die in prison.
You bastard mouth!
All I know is Renault and Morris are not about.
Well, it's not fair. They should tell us.
Oh, they don't trust us. Scared of what we might do.
Well, the press must know about it, otherwise they wouldn't have taken our television or radios away, would they?
Would it have something to do with whoever's in isolation?
No, I doubt it. All the cops are in administration. There was no one guarding the steps to isolation when I came past. I wish to bloody hell we could find out what's going on.
Come on, get inside.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? Get out of here.
Get out, Warren.
Hey, who's the sponge?
Just a workman.
Something about his mother. Maybe. I hope it's not just wishful thinking. Maybe the police are onto him. Oh, then they'll find us soon. Well, there's a chance.
It'll be all right then. All we have to do is just sit tight. And they'll find us.
We'll wait. For a little while.
And so I made up some story about the boy being a workman. She obviously didn't believe me.
I was afraid something like this might happen.
So was I, so don't go blaming me. How the hell was I to know that kid?
Oh, for heaven's sake, Joan, I need your help, not an argument. It's bad enough having this murder investigation on our hands. What do we do now?
We? It's not my decision to make. You're the governor.
Well, thank you for reminding me. In that case, I think we should tell the women the truth and trust to their common sense. You obviously don't agree.
I thought you wanted help. You honestly don't expect any cooperation from that lot.
Yes, I do. Considering they've had all their privileges suspended without any explanation, I think they've behaved very well, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Aside from murdering the occasional visiting justice, they've been wonderful.
All right. That's enough. Look, I didn't ask for this job. And to be honest, I'm not sure I'm the best person for it. But I am the governor, and I've got enough on my plate without listening to all this rubbish. So if you're not going to help me, keep out of my way. Now, I suggest we tell the women.
And it really killed my hand, but I didn't mind, because I would never have seen him if I hadn't had to go...
Rabbit, slow down. Seen who?
The guy in the examining room in uniform. Oh, what a spunk. I'm here to tell you.
Burn your hand, you bumped your head.
Oh, it could have been a cop.
Oh, come on.
Well, you said he was in uniform.
A bloody Woodridge uniform. And isolation must be packed with him because of all the food Ray's sending up there. And I'll tell you something else. Every time I mention Mrs. M and Reno, he almost burst into tears. You want to know what I reckon? I reckon they're up there in isolation with all them guys.
Oh, come on, Marlene. Pull the other one.
No, it's true. What would they be doing there?
Place is full of men, dummy. What do you think?
Mrs. Reynolds and Mrs. Morris are ladies. They wouldn't do that.
We don't think there are men in isolation.
Let's find out.
Well, ladies, as you probably know, I'm to be acting as governor while Mrs. Reynolds is away. Now, those of you who have yet to be interviewed by Inspector Grace will probably be questioned by him during the day.
And?
I expect Marlene has already told you that we have some, well, unusual guests upstairs.
What did I tell you?
The department has sent us three prisoners from Woodridge. Now, the men are to be kept in isolation for protective custody.
Give me half a chance, I'll protect their custody. Joke, Joyce.
Oh, that's enough, Warren. How long are they expected to be here?
I don't know. That's up to the department. But don't worry, it won't change anything here. You'll probably never even get to see them.
Butter.
Oh, sorry, Bobbie. Well, ladies, I'll let you get back to your work.
Thanks, Mrs. B. Okay, Warren. Since you're well enough to carry towels to your mates, get back to your kitchen duties.
Oh, Miss Ferguson, I've only got one hand.
All right, Mason, Mitchell, kitchen duty. And your tubby friend here can find something to do that requires only one hand and one big mouth. Come on, you two, out.
I don't think she likes me. Oh,
you all right, mate? Bit crooked, Geoff.
Tell him how you let the cat out of the bag, sonny. Old prison knows you're here by now. You know what that means, don't you?
You'd like that, wouldn't you, Spud?
Kid's a gutless wonder. Little poofter like that deserves all he gets.
Gutless wonder, eh, Murphy? This kid took a beating he'll never forget, yet I never heard him complain, not once. You reckon you could say the same?
You got a big mouth, Macrae. About time somebody shut it for you.
You're welcome to try, Spud. Wouldn't be the first time.
Fight, you bastards. I hate peace.
Don't worry, Burke. You won't be getting much from now on.
Look, you hate our guts and it's mutual, but don't blame the kid for what happened. Sooner or later, someone was going to find out, so let's just drop it.
Maybe they won't keep us locked up in here now. Wouldn't mind a bit of fresh air every now and again.
Still missing the country, are you, sonny?
All we need is a little exercise.
Well, why don't we just send you back to Woodridge? I'm sure the boys there will give you plenty of exercise if they get their hands on you.
They wouldn't send us back there, would they, Geoff?
No, mate. Of course not.
Anne? I'm sorry, my arm went to sleep.
The police, are they here yet?
There are no police, Meg. If they were coming, they'd have been here a long time ago.
When was the last time we heard him?
3/4, maybe an hour ago. That was a big crash. Something must have happened to him. Come on.
What are we doing? What are you doing?
No one's coming to get us, Meg. No one even knows we're here. If we want to live, we have to get out and we have to do it ourselves. Do you understand?
I can't. I want to. I can't.
All right, you stay here and rest. I have to find that mechanism.
And the wires. Please be careful. No! Don't! I thought it was wires.
We were both wrong, weren't we?
But I can see him now.
But what is it? What is it?
Help me, Meg!
Why? I can't believe it. He didn't wire the door. He didn't have to. He wired the doorway instead. Made me laugh. I just can't.
It's all right, Meg. I'm clear. We're gonna make it.
We're going to get out of this place. For God's sake, Anne, don't humour me. We're going to die in this filthy hole. We haven't got a chance.
Keep thinking like that and we will die. You can give up if you like, but I'm going to get out and I can do it with or without your help. It's up to you.
Any more on the blokes upstairs?
Desmond's making a lot of noise, but she's just going around in circles.
What do you reckon, though? Could be good for a laugh, eh?
Could be good for a lot of things, if you're still around to see him.
What's that supposed to mean?
I just reckon you're pretty stupid wandering around on your own. Whoever killed Sarah Higgins could be just around the next corner. Unless, of course, you're pretty sure you're safe.
Hang on. You're saying I killed Higgins?
You're saying you didn't?
Oh, bugger me. I thought you did it.
Well, you were the one sounding off about killing the bitch.
Yeah, that's right. So I'd be bloody silly to go and do it, wouldn't I? Anyway, you could put everyone's name in a hat and draw a winner. They all wanted her dead.
Let's just hope the cops don't jump to the same conclusions we did.
They can't pin it on me. I didn't do it.
Pretty interesting, though, eh?
What?
We didn't do it. Who did?
I'm sure I'm going to have nightmares about it for ages. I mean, she wasn't a nice person, but she didn't deserve to die like that. Who do you think did it?
I don't know and I don't care. Right now there's bigger fish to fry.
Fish? I thought we were having shepherd's pie for lunch. Oh, Kimmy's up there.
Is there anything extra you want to put on this note?
Oh, I don't know, Bobbie. I don't think we should be writing that note. I mean, it's awfully formal.
Pixie, we never get any bloody excitement around here. Now there's three blokes up there. One for me, one for you, one left over for a spare, and you want to chicken out.
I'm not chicken.
No, we're not having chicken today. Heaven knows, I'm doing the best I can. You two, please do some work here.
Jeez, what's wrong with everybody? He's got the bloody miseries, and now you hate fellas.
I do not. It's just that I don't want to get married anymore, so what's the point in being interested?
Who said anything about bloody getting married? You can't be friends with a bloke, you know.
Friends? With a man? Oh, no, Bobbie, I don't think that'll ever catch on.
Here goes. How does it look?
Oh, very artistic, but food is for eating, not for playing with.
Jeez, what's wrong with you? Anyone would think someone had died or something.
You think it's funny to be dead, don't you? Well, I don't think so. It's bad enough to think that poor Mrs. Reynolds and Mrs. Morris are kidnapped by a lunatic. But what? When you make jokes about death just after that dear boy Philip has been murdered. No, I won't have it.
And I reckon if we holler loud enough, they got to let them blokes out, don't you?
Well, let's face it, men are a pretty scarce commodity around here.
They can keep three blokes away from 40 women.
Well, it's not you, actually, it's Bobbie. I have to know, where was she last night?
How do you mean? She was in...
You get more than that if you play your cards.
Murray, you don't think Bobbie... interested. She was with me the whole time.
Good, I thought so. I'm sorry, love, but I had to ask.
I suppose...
You are out of your mind if you think that...
She's on the top of the list.
Guys... For God's sake, they're prisoners.
Yeah, well, they let us mix with the guys at Woodridge, didn't they?
Yeah, and that was a bloody disaster, wasn't it?
This is different. They're on our territory now.
No, Jude's right. It'll only mean trouble. Besides, we don't know what they're in for.
So what?
You and your fat friend are in for murder, so what's the diff?
The difference is that if you don't shut up, I'm going to rearrange your face.
Drop it, love. She's got a point. Anyway, we're not the only murderers here. In fact, someone's still doing it. If you all get my meaning...
Why? Oh, thank God.
What the hell's going on?
Mitchell, she's off her head. Hurry.
Bloody hell.
Bloody hell. He shouldn't have left me. Everybody left me. Stan, Cass, Mr. Crookshank, Mr. Manning. Everybody leaves me.
Please help her.
Easy now, kid. Put the knife down, eh?
Don't leave me, you bastard. Bill was worth a million of you and the freak. Why? Why did he have to die? Why do all the good people have to die?
Oh, Ross, I didn't got no
sense.
You keep
it. Bull, maybe
I'll try and get around
safe.
Behind her.
Being dead's better than this. Anything is.
You don't mean that, Bobbie. Now, what happened was a terrible thing. We all feel the same way.
No, you don't. Bill was my mate.
I know. So he wouldn't want you to do anything stupid now, would he?
You wouldn't know. You don't understand. I don't want to know anymore. I just want to die!
Not today, sweetheart.
Oh, Bobbie.
Everybody leaves me. Everybody.
How many women do you reckon they've got in here?
Haven't given it much thought.
Yeah, you've forgotten what it's for, Macrae. As far as I'm concerned, they're all down there for one purpose. Me.
Give it a break, Weasel.
Be careful, darling. You're starting to look real sexy to me.
Leave the kid alone, Frank.
Leave him? It's his bloody fault we're cooped up in this cage. If those blokes ever get hold of us again, they'll kill us.
I didn't know what was happening. If somebody had told me, I would have been able to...
Tell you? You've got to be joking. You did enough damage without knowing.
20 men in a mass breakout, it wouldn't have worked, and you know it. The kid wasn't to blame.
It would have worked all right. Why do you think they've locked us up in this prison without anyone knowing where we are? The brass don't want to admit that little Patty here buggered up an escape they didn't even know about. Well, look at these. 2 days old and there's nothing in them. Stuck in a bloody female prison and forgotten.
Okay, so none of us like it, but we've got to live with it.
I mean, he has. I could have explained. Hell, what did I know? I'd only come out of the pound 5 minutes.
Sorry, I didn't know.
Yeah, well, you know now, don't you? Stuck in this dump with Spud Murphy breathing down your neck. The meanest bastard in uniform. Oh, yeah, you'll know, all right.
He's as bad as they say he is, Geoff. I've heard stories about him.
Murphy can be handled.
Pigs.
Hello, clean this mess up. Your food's here.
Great. I bet that's the highlight of our day.
He's not there. Well, just hang on a minute, will you?
Yes, I heard. Find out when he'll be back, would you?
Could you tell us when he'll be back?
Oh, Pat, I'm sorry. I got caught up here. How's Mitchell?
Oh, well, she's under sedation.
No, thanks anyway. Mason's all right. Mrs. Barry, she might get back to you.
Well, there's no chance the women won't find out now, is there?
You just have to wait.
Thanks very much.
Oh, much else we can do.
The Wiseman's out of town till the end of next week.
Oh, thanks, Sue. Now what? I think that girl needs to talk to someone, don't you?
There must be someone we can call.
The only person I can think of is Phil Cleary's friend, Chris Sutton. He's a psychologist.
Do you think he'd come?
Oh, it's a very bad time. He and Phil were close, but... at least we can try. Oh, and Pat, tell Ray Proctor I want to talk to him after lunch, would you?
All right, but he's very upset.
We all are, Pat. None of this need have happened if only... well, something has to be said, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, how much longer do we have to wait?
You'll get your food just as soon as it's ready.
Oh, God, why don't you just tell us what the holdup is? At least we can
understand. Did you hear me, Bryant? Shut up and wait.
All we want to know is when we're going to eat.
Now, Desmond. Hang on, Desmond. Listen, you keep your girls in check and tell them to cut out the lip. I wouldn't want to get heavy again.
What? Anything you say.
Oh, my God, Bobbie,
Mr. Murphy.
We're going to go and see her.
What's wrong?
Mr. Cleary's been murdered and Bobbie tried to kill herself.
Oh, my God.
Pixie, you sure you haven't got it mixed up?
And Mrs. Reynolds and Mrs. Morris have been kidnapped.
Kidnapped?
And Ray's really upset about the whole thing.
Now, look, you wanted your food. Now, get to it. I don't know what you're talking about. Now, look, eat your food.
Is it true? Now, look, we're not kids. We want to know what's going on.
It's none of your business.
Like hell it isn't.
I want to see the governor.
After lunch.
Now.
I said after lunch. Now, don't push your luck. Any of you.
Bill. It's all right. I'm so thirsty.
At least the food's all right. Something different every day.
You reckon? Can't even chew the bloody... Oh, terrific. I'm so bloody plastic.
Someone leave the shopping list in it.
Hey, get a load of this. We know you're up there. They won't let us see you, but we will send notes when we can. Or rather, they send us a bloody file.
At least someone knows we're up here.
Sure they do. They're trying to think of ways we can give it to them. But you'd only have to touch them and they'd go off like a rocket.
Maybe they just want to talk to us. You ever thought of that, Frank?
Frank, you've got to be joking. Now, look, come. Let's just finish eating, shall we?
Hang on, there's more. Right back, put the note in any leftovers. Your new friend, Bobbie. P.S. I hope you like natural redhead. I don't care if they're bald as long as they do it.
I'll say one thing for you, Frank. You're consistent and bloody monotonous.
Then how about we break the monotony and write back?
Oh, come on. That's kid stuff.
Wouldn't hurt, though, would it? I mean, you like having someone to talk to.
I couldn't have put it better myself. Now, where do we start?
Get hold of something. If I can get my foot up the step behind me.
Yeah. Your foot, it's over the wire.
But
if I pull hard, then you're on. Hook your foot. Put it on the banister. Have to.
Doesn't make sense. Why would you go to all that trouble? Get that money and then not show up to collect it.
Well, it's still not that late. I mean, it could be something really stupid, like his car breaking down. Besides, he's in no hurry. He mightn't do the pickup till next week.
No way. When berserk when I told him we had his mother. Now he'll show up and try to get her out here as quick as possible.
What do you want to do about her? Do you want to lay charges?
What charges? Nah. Hold her, though. She's the only hope we've got. Have I had lunch?
I'll get some sandwiches.
Yeah. Oh, and Murray, tell them to put out an all points on every building within 2 km of that phone and tell Ben to hang on at Spencer Street.
Right.
You bastard, where are you?
And we even had a reply from you-know-who. Well, don't you want to hear?
Time's up, Pixie.
Oh, please, Mrs. Radcliffe.
Well, all right, but only for a minute.
Come on, Bobbie, you have to eat something, otherwise you'll get ill and... Oh, I'm sorry. Just that the whole thing's so awful. We're all going to miss him terribly. Even though you were his favourite. Ray was crying in the kitchen and Mrs. Barry was very angry with him. And Myra and everybody, well, they're just shocked. Oh, golly, and here I am crying and you're just being so brave.
Can't cry, Pix. I'm never going to care about anyone again. No point, is there?
And everyone was so bloody busy taking the telly and radios away. Did it ever occur to them that if they trusted us, we might have been able to help?
It was the department's decision, Myra. Maybe it would have been better if you'd been kept in the picture, but I honestly don't see what you could have done.
For starters, it would have been a lot easier on Bobbie. If we'd all been told together that... Mrs. Barry, we are not monsters. We care what happens to the Governor and Mrs. M. We liked Phil Cleary, too.
Of course, I know that.
Then tell it to the department. What did they think we were going to do when we found out? Start a riot?
Something like that, yes.
Oh, you've got to be joking. When are they going to realise that we can behave like responsible adults?
Look, as Governor, I shouldn't say this, but yes, you're right. You should have been told the truth. But, God, I need all the help I can get, and everything happens so quickly around me.
Mrs. Barry, look, I'm not blaming you. But now that the cat's out of the bag, can I at least tell the women that the restrictions are lifted? There'll be a lot less trouble if they're not bored gutless.
I was about to suggest that myself. And don't worry too much about young Bobbie. I'm making sure she's getting the best possible treatment.
Yeah, well, she'll pull through. She's a survivor. Let's hope we can say the same about the Governor and Mrs. M.
Well, you can tell the women I'm expecting some news at any moment. I'm sure they'll be all right.
You heard something?
No, but Inspector Rouse has got everything under control. I'm certain they'll be safe.
Yeah, well, I hope to God you're right.
The worst part was she couldn't cry. Oh, I knew she wanted to, but she just wouldn't. I wanted to put my arms around and hug her, but I knew she wouldn't let me.
Oh, Bobbie, she really liked Mr. Cleary.
Yeah, well, we all did, love.
Speak for yourself, take the jeans and the softball that way and he was just another screw.
You shut your mouth, Francis. He was decent to us, now shut up.
Poor old Mrs. Morris, it's not fair, you know. She certainly doesn't deserve another lousy break.
Maybe she won't make it either. That way she won't have to worry, will she?
Shut up, Kelly! Mrs. Morris got more guts than you'll ever have!
Oh, now, Rabbit, stop. Look,
just... So is Mrs. Reynolds.
Okay. Myra, what'd she say?
Well, we get back all our privileges. Not much point in keeping the news from us now.
Well, what about Mrs. Morris and Mrs. Reynolds? I mean, they're not...
No, it's okay, love. Mrs. Barry seems to think they'll be back any tick of the clock.
You mean everything's back to normal?
No, it's not, Marlene. We've still got Higgins's murder hanging over our heads. All of us. After all I said about not touching her, too. Now, the cops may blow it and give the whole case away, but I'm not going to. Someone didn't do what they were told. And I'm going to find out who it is. How long it takes.
You reckon there's no such thing as ghosts? Why don't you go in there and check it out?
There's no point. There's no bloody ghost anyhow.
Yeah, chicken.
Okay, nerd. You dared me, I'll double dare you. I'll go in if you do.
Yeah, why not?
Okay. It's locked. Try another door.
Please, wait.
Then when we were kids, it was like a sort of contest. Friendly one, of course, but... well, if I was getting a bike, Philip would have to have one too. We even had broken arms at the same time. All those years in the States, we hardly ever wrote. But it didn't matter. When he came back, it was as though he'd never been away. Bobbie, he thought the world of you. It's easy to see how you felt about him. But you're keeping it all locked inside and you've got to let it out. It's not a sign of weakness, you know. Just the opposite. If you feel like having a cry, go ahead. I know I have.
Who are you?
Ah, just a friend of Phil's.
It's not what I mean. Who are you? What do you do?
I'm a psychologist, but that's not why I'm here.
You're a shrink! You're going to try and trick me! Get out of here! Just get out!
Bobbie, Mr. Sutton?
It's all right. It's all right. Bobbie.
Just leave me alone. Get out and leave me alone.
Hey, Warren, what are you doing? Looking for cockroaches?
Shut up.
It wasn't my idea. You were the one that was big-noting yourself.
Yeah, well, I'm too upset now. There's more important things than just gambling, you know.
Yeah, I know that, but I didn't know you did. I'm surprised you haven't started a book on who killed Leary Cleary. I reckon you could clean up on that if you gave it right on.
It's a rotten thing to say, Lou.
I'd have to be as big a bitch as you to even think of it. Now shut up or I'll shove a sheet down your throat.
Geez, I'll say one thing for you, Warren. You're good for a laugh. Pretty full of yourself with Desmond to back you up.
Oh, now
that's enough! Cut it out,
you little bitch! You'll kill one day with a temper like that. You're looking for a murderer, aren't you?
I wouldn't put her high on the list. What are you looking at me for?
Why not?
Oh, go play Sherlock Holmes someplace else. I couldn't have done it. I was with Alice.
Doing what?
Thinking up ways to stick it up you. If you don't believe me, go and ask her.
Don't worry.
Love, she'll be okay. Oh, Miss Radcliffe, what's the news on Bobby?
She's fine. Right now, she's getting the best medicine, a long sleep.
Thanks.
Sleep that rolls off the ruffled sleeve of hair.
Bible.
No, Shakespeare. Or is it? Or is it out of the...
Birthday come early.
Ah, this lot wouldn't go far. Still, helps, doesn't it?
Yeah. You're getting on pretty well with the women now, aren't you?
Well, about time, isn't it? I've wasted enough energy being aggro.
Yeah, it's good. Makes things easier all round. Except...
except what? Come on, Myra, you're talking about Higgins again, aren't you?
You hated her guts. Had every reason to see her dead.
Hang on a minute. You're going to make yourself sick worrying about this thing. First you thought it was Lou,
no,
now you...
No, I don't think it's Lou. In fact, I've got proof now.
What do you mean?
Murder weapon. Razor blade. I found it.
It has been a terrible mistake.
I don't sense the alcohol. I'm a diabetic.
Just don't breathe on the counter, mate. You'll strip the bar.
Take your hands off me, you bloody pig. I know me right.
Yeah, sure you do.
Yeah, I know you right.
Who are you?
I think this is for you, Murray. A couple of kids say they found a body in a condemned building a few hours back. It could be nothing, but
I'll take it. Hello.
Oh, Ripper, I heard you got some goodies.
They're not for eating. Anyway, you might not have much appetite. You seen Desmond?
What's up?
She found the razor blade.
What?
Sarah Higgins.
So I told you I didn't do it.
Yeah, well, someone's in for a pretty lousy time. If you know
who... I don't. I wouldn't warn them anyhow. That's their tough luck. You reckon Desmond's on the level?
Who knows? She could be bluffing. Anyway, we've got business to take care of.
What do you got in mind?
I've been thinking about the boys upstairs.
You're not the only one.
Hey, keep yourself nice. It's inhuman, though, isn't it? Keeping them up there. I reckon the papers would have a field day if they found out about it.
And how are we going to do that?
Ooh, press moves in mysterious ways. Who do we know who could crack a story that big?
Camilla Wells.
Right. She made a big enough stink about the inhuman conditions. The department would have to do something. Who knows? Might even let them mix with us.
Oh, what a joke, eh? Screws turning on a bit of nookie for us. Boy, I hope one of them's a stud. What's wrong with that?
Nothing. You're just not thinking, that's all. Those three guys must be pretty heavy if Woodridge couldn't hold them. Still, if we can get to meet them, maybe we can use them.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Extra muscle, eh? Then we can crack a few skulls and really move in. Hang on. Supposing they want something more than our bodies?
Yeah, thought of that. Still, if they're not into sex, they'll be into drugs. Either way, we can keep them happy and run the business.
You're jumping the gun a bit, aren't you? We haven't even got the dope in yet.
Haven't we?
Sister? Sister Hall?
About the army. He must have made friends when he was in name.
Yeah, maybe, but he's been a bloody long time in the can since then. Okay, take a punt. Give Canberra a
call. You might have something. Some kids phoned in, a body in the condemned building pretty close to that phone.
Probably an old derry. We've had three calls today. None of them checked out.
How close is close?
Just outside the 2 kilometre radius. That's why we hadn't checked it.
Yeah. Yeah, it makes sense. Explain why he never came near that money. Yeah, I like it. Murray, get a car on it right away.
Already have put out an APB on the nearest unit.
Good. Now, have all units got ID on him?
Yep.
Right, we'll get them on the radio. Tell them if it's positive they're to stay, they're to call in, but they're not to touch a thing till I get there, understand?
Right.
Busy?
No, only knock, will you?
Sorry. Thought we might have a chat about last night.
How do you mean? Look, I know what you're getting at, but I was with Alice right after we left the workroom.
Lou was with Alice. Neither of them mentioned you.
Wait a minute. I remember now. Jacko wanted me to lend her some rollers.
Sorry. Jacko was with Tammy. Strange, isn't it? How everybody seemed to be with somebody. Except you.
I don't need no alibi. Well, not for you, anyhow.
Oh, I think you do. Especially now. You see, I found the razor blade.
I flushed it down the toilet.
You stupid little bitch, after all I said.
Are you going to tell the cops?
What, with no evidence?
But you said...
You said you flushed it down the loo. How could I possibly have it?
Rotten.
You thank your lucky stars it was me and not them. Now, you're going to pay Harvey, not just for killing Higgins, but for going against my orders. I'm going to teach you who's in charge around here, and I promise you it'll be a lesson you'll never forget.
What do you reckon, Barry?
Looks quiet enough. Come on. You all right?
Yeah.
6 months on the force and never seen a stiff.
Don't worry, you'll be okay.
Supposed to touch anything.
Promotion, old son. You'll never get anywhere doing what you're told. Well, I never said that. There's our man.
Is he dead?
As the dodo. Get on the radio and tell him we got positive ID. Well, as positive as you can be. 10-year-old photo.
Look at this.
You hit the jackpot, mate. Police! Anybody up there?
I could be dead.
Or 100 miles away. Here, hold this.
What are you gonna do?
I'm going up to check it out. You get on the radio.
But...
Come on, mate. You don't want me to pull rank on you, do you?
Dreamed we were together, sharing.